another episode of The Secrets of Science. And we know now, okay, we've talked that everything moves because of force. If I toss this apple up in the air, you know, it goes up because I applied a force. But that reminds me of a guy in 1665. His name was Isaac Newton. And something you're actually familiar with, he had to come home because of the plague, the bubonic plague that was affecting and impacting. So he had to go home from college. And the story goes that he noticed that an apple fell out of a tree. And he began to think about, why did that apple fall straight down out of the tree? Kind of a simple idea, but he began to think about it. And he noticed other things, like the moon. And he began to wonder, is it possible that the very same thing that caused the apple to fall was what made the moon stay in orbit around the Earth? Is gravity, this thing they had talked about, gravity, is that actually influencing and pulling and holding the moon in? Turns out he was on to something. Now it turns out that actually a lot was already known. I mean, I wouldn't say a lot, but things were already known about gravity. 100 years earlier or so, Galileo had performed an experiment where he climbed up, the story goes, to the Leaning Tower of Pisa, and he speculated that if two objects were made of the same material but were different masses, that if you drop them, gravity would pull them the same. So actually behind me, it's not really an apple tree, it's a walnut tree. And so we could take this example of two walnuts, and if we were to climb the Leaning Tower of Pisa, or, well, this is not really a Tower of Pisa, and we were to do a little experiment where we drop these at the same time, we could see the result. You know, it was a simple concept of gravity, universal gravity, but Newton was actually a mathematician. He was a genius, and he actually calculated how fast the moon was moving and how much it would drop in a second. And he compared that to how fast objects on Earth, like an apple, would fall in a second. And he came up with this law about gravity that said that the farther you are away from something, gravity decreases, okay, by a certain amount. I mean, he was very specific about it. He said it's the inverse of the distance squared, whatever that means, right? But the basic idea is that the farther something away from each other, the less pull of gravity there is. And the larger the mass of something, the more gravity there is. And it's this idea that all objects have gravity. You have gravity. I have gravity. But it's not really enough to really notice because we're not big enough. But the Earth or the moon, now that's where you start to see a noticeable difference in space. Pretty amazing stuff. And again, he calculated this out, and that's really what he is famous for. This idea that the Earth is strong enough and massive enough to pull objects towards it, that's why objects actually weigh something. So let me give you an example of 100 grams. And weigh that out. Let's take, for example, 100 grams. Okay, 100 grams. And the reason it is 100 grams is it's because on Earth we have the pull of gravity, and that gives it a certain weight. Or we could take a spring scale, and the pull of gravity causes this to be a certain weight. Now, what if you went to the moon, for example? Would it still weigh 100 grams? No, the pull wouldn't be as much. So it would be lighter than 100 grams. But the same amount of material is going to be there. It's going to have the same mass. Newton also had an idea that what if he went to the top of a mountain and he shot a cannonball fast enough that he knew it would curve because of gravity, but what if it could just curve right around the earth? I guess it'd be similar, like what if I could throw this apple fast enough that you know it's gonna curve and it could just curve and go right around the earth and just keep going. And Newton had this idea that that's why objects stay in motion. That's why the moon is locked in orbit. That's why the planets are locked in orbit. The pull of gravity in their speed, and it turns out Newton was exactly right. We're going to investigate gravity and some of the interesting things about it. It's mysterious. You can't see it, but we know objects have it, and especially when we look into space, we see the effects of gravity. It certainly is one of the secrets of science that scientists still look at today. And we'll hope to understand that better. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this episode of The Secrets of Science as we learn more about gravity and we unlock the mysteries of this universe.